Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be explaining you radar waveforms for pulsed radar system, and based on waveforms, I'll be deriving maximum unambiguous range for pulsed radar system. So first of all, one should know what is pulsed radar system. See, pulsed radar system transmits EM wave for short duration of pulse. So for short duration of time, high power, high frequency signal that is being transmitted by pulsed radar system. And after sending that pulse, it will be waiting for short duration. During that short duration, it will be waiting for echo signal. And here, based on transmitted and received signal, that radar will be identifying range of the target. Let me show it to you by animation. See, here we have pulsed radar system that is transmitting high power signal. That signal could be there in terms of few kilovolts to megavolts. And from the target, by red color, you can observe we have reflected echo signal. That reflected wave that is there in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 watt to 10 to the power minus 15 watt. So here, for short duration of time, we are transmitting EM wave. After that, we are waiting for echo signal. And based on comparison of transmitted wave and received wave, this radar system will be identifying range of this object. Now, I'll explain you that with respect to waveform, that will give you more clarity. See, in waveform, on y-axis, I'll be considering power, and on x-axis, I'll be considering time duration. First of all, let us talk about transmitted signal. So you can observe during this pulse, we are transmitting EM wave. See, we are not transmitting pulse over here. We are transmitting electromagnetic waves during this time interval of pulse. So inside this pulse, with this antenna, we will be transmitting high frequency signal. That signal will be having frequency in terms of gigahertz, right? And width of this pulse, that will be there in terms of microsecond, right? So here, see, during this pulse, we will be transmitting EM wave over here. And here we have reflected wave that you can observe by this red color. That is reflected wave, or you can say it is echo signal. Here, power of transmitted signal that is considered with 1 megawatt. So peak power that is of 1 megawatt over here. And with reflected wave, peak power is 10 to the power minus 12 watt. So you can say transmitted wave that is having very high power and received signal that is having very low power, right? Here, there are few essential parameters that you need to understand first. See, in between two pulse, time delay is T. And based on that time delay, we can have pulse repetitive frequency. So pulse repetition frequency, that is 1 by T, where T is time delay in between two consecutive pulse. And as I have told you, see, width of this pulse, that is very narrow. And based on that, one can identify duty cycle. If I say T on duration over here, that is this, then duty cycle will be T on divided by total time duration T. Here, with pulsed radar system, duty cycle will be around 0.001. In terms of percentage, it will be 0.1. So here, we are having very narrow width of pulse, right? And during that pulse, we will be transmitting high frequency signal, right? So T on, that is very narrow over here. After this T on, this radar that will be waiting for reflected signal. And based on reflected signal, it will be comparing delay, and based on delay, it will be identifying range. So here, we are dealing with to select T on and pulse repetitive frequency for proper operation of pulsed radar system. See, this pulse repetitive frequency and T on, these are the two parameters that we need to select at this system. And based on those two parameters, we can identify whether radar system is perfectly functioning or not, right? So here there are a few basics that you need to understand. See, with this waveform, this time delay t, that should be sufficient enough to wait for this reflected wave, right? So once pulse is transmitted by radar, sufficient length of time must be elapsed to allow any echo signals to return and be detected before next pulse may be transmitted. So here, before you send next pulse, you will have to receive this echo signal, right? See, if you increase frequency, in that case, this delay that will decrease, and as if this delay is decreasing, then there is high chances that this reflected pulses that may arrive after second pulse, right? So here, the rate at which pulses may be transmitted is determined by the longest range at which targets are expected. See, based on targets, we are dealt with to select the pulse repetitive frequency. Like for example, if I say right now we are having this reflected wave that is coming from 400 kilometer distance, right? Then this delay will be coming somewhere over here. Now, as if that target that is there at 500 kilometer distance, then this pulse that will be coming somewhere over here. So we need to know first, what is the expected range of target? Based on that, we should be selecting that pulse repetitive frequency. Here you need to understand pulse repetitive frequency in terms of this time duration t, where this t is delay in between two consecutive pulses. So if you increase pulse repetitive frequency, then this delay will decrease. As if this delay is decreasing, then there are higher chances that ambiguities get entered in the measurement, right? See, if the pulse repetitive frequency is too high, echo signals from the target might arrive after the transmission of next pulse, so ambiguities in the measuring range is identified. Like as if I consider this pulse repetitive frequency that is double right now. So by animation, I am showing you right now we are having double of this pulse repetitive frequency. So in that case, what will happen? You see, for this pulse, we will be receiving echo after second pulse. So here you can say this is ambiguous echo, right? And as this is ambiguous echo, range identification will be false over here, right? So we should be lowering pulse repetitive frequency over here to have proper identification of target, right? Here, right now, with this condition, we are having proper reception of signal. There is no ambiguity with this, right? But if you increase frequency, then there are higher chances that ambiguities may get entered inside. Now, let us try to understand how we can have maximum range calculation, right? So maximum unambiguous range, that I'm going to explain you now. See, maximum unambiguous range means what? It is a range without any ambiguity, right? So without any ambiguity, what can be the maximum range over here with given radar system? So that is purely based on selection of this time interval t. Here one should know, see, round trip time of echo signal, that is tp, right? Here you can observe this reflected wave that is having round trip time, that is tp. This tp, that should be lower than this t, right? This tp, that should be lower than this t. Then only you can have proper reception of signal. Otherwise, there can be ambiguity inside, right? And here, range calculation that I have already explained in my last video. Range is how much? Range is ct divided by 2, where c is velocity of light and t is delay. Here, this value of t, that should be greater than tp for unambiguous range of measurement, right? So here, see, r unambiguous, that is what, that explains you up to what distance this radar can measure targets properly, right? So lower than that range can be identified by radar properly, right? So this is what maximum unambiguous range. If you want this equation in terms of pulse repetitive frequency, then you can simply place t is equals to fprf. So your maximum unambiguous range, that will be c divided by 2 fprf. That is how we can identify maximum unambiguous range of radar. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.